There are lots of different types of pig housing in Australia. Some of them can be climatically controlled housing, which means they have fans and evaporative cooling up one end. And then other types are in straw-based igloos, which is what we're seeing here. It probably started in olden days where they just wallowed and they had older pigsties that lots of farms had on their smaller pigsties on their farms. Then there were probably more intensive concrete pens, fully slatted concrete pens. And I think with the disease pressure and pigs living on top of one another, management practices had to change. Here in straw-based systems, they actually use the straw to nest into, and they actually can keep themselves warm and cool by actually nesting in the straw, which is getting back to the earlier days of housing pig animals. Actually, back in the day, used to cover themselves in mud as not only a cooling mechanism, but it actually was to keep the sun from giving them sunburn. They can't put their own sunscreen on like we can, so we obviously have to have the tarpaulins on the roofs to keep them from getting sunburned. We can also adjust the blinds, the side blinds and the end louvers on the sheds, so that daily, when we're checking the pigs, we can shut them up at night, because obviously it gets cooler at night, and then we can open them up during the day. And even in small wind gusts, it can create its own tunnel ventilation, because the pig always enjoys a little bit of airflow. Much like humans, they like that perfect Mediterranean sort of climate. They would love perfect temperatures, but of course in Australia we do not have perfect temperatures. We actually, if you can see up there, we have spray coolers as well, for in the really hot times we will have spray cooling. We are very lucky, and in terms of having a clean green image, we actually don't have any power at this site, which is good for in the future. You can see where energy costs are going of having to use power to run engines and motors. We actually blow the feed up with a truck into those silos you can see down the end. And then I think you can even see that the piglets are actually eating by just gravity. And as they eat, the grain falls down. So really, they can look after themselves. We don't actually have to feed these pigs every morning or night. They are actually fed what they call ad lib, which means they have food whenever they want. But they will actually sleep most of the night and eat and rest during the day. They might spend anywhere in the vicinity of 10 to 12 weeks in this shed, and then they will move up into a bigger shed, still staying in the same group. So 12 weeks here, and then probably 10 to 12 weeks up there, until they are probably 100 kilo live weight. And that is when they would go to market as what we would call a bacon a pig. We actually have a piggery at another part of the state, which doesn't have straw based. It does for one portion of their growing up, like the weaner ones like we see here today, but then they go into a fully climatically controlled shed. So it is actually air conditioned with evaporative cooling, and it actually has fans up one end, sucking all of the stale air out. They are actually fed also, not by gravity fed, they're actually fed by a computer which pumps liquid like a big soup slurry to them, and they actually eat a slurry. In some of our actual breeding sites, we'll actually have evaporative air conditioning to keep the mums cooler while they're having their babies. With these better housing systems, we've been able to create a lot better environment, because pigs are actually one of the cleanest animals in the world if you give them the correct environment to live in.